Hello there, this is Lazouche Custom Shop here with the third part of my Bill Wilson custom carry pistol custom job. This is what I aim to finish up with. Now, fair enough, I'm not going to be doing the chromed blue frame. I'm going to do a little bit of a different sort of take on it than this. Now then, in this part I'm going to show how to fit the grip safety to the frame. Now then, I know I've gone over this before in other videos, but just to give you an idea that it's not all done behind the scenes by somebody else, all you do is, before you start, is offer that up to the back of the frame, like so. Now the tangs on the frame, which are these two bits either side, they'll need to be rounded down in order to get this to fit. Now this, the other thing you've got to do, which again I've said on other numerous videos, is there's a little cutout that'll need to be done just in the back of the grip safety, which goes against that bar there. I don't know if you can make that out, just there. That's the only way you'll get a, well, this actually is from a Marui 5.1 high cap. I've had to grind out or cut out using a hacksaw and files that little bit to go around that bar. Otherwise, this won't fit. That's the only difference I've had to do to get it to fit. Okay, so you just offer that up there, mark off roughly how much you want to take off. I mean, I can do this by eye now, I've been doing it so often. Get yourself a fairly rough but hard steel file, and then literally just grind it away, and then you just keep doing that, rounding it off all the time, making sure that you keep that dead level. I.e., if you start coming off too much on one, make sure you even it up on the other, but never take off too much. Always test fit, try it. No, as you can see, the hole's not quite lined up there, so again you do some more, keep taking it off. Again, making sure that it's level. By the way, this is an ABS plastic frame. It's a spare frame I had. You can do this with a metal frame, but obviously you'll need to use a bit more elbow grease with the file, or get yourself a Dremel. I have got a Dremel here, but it's just easier and more accurate to do it by hand. Okay, offering it up. Anyway, you can see the idea. So you just keep going on with that until you eventually get to that, which is, as you can see, nicely rounded, no gaps, no gaps down there. It's pretty much spot on, and that's it. This, as they say, is one I prepared earlier. I've fitted the grips, fitted all the internals, done all of the slides. I lubricated them, test fired it as well, and she works okay. I'm getting a slight double trigger problem. That, as I've explained on other videos, is either down to the disconnector not engaging correctly, or it's the three finger spring in there, again to do with the disconnector. The right hand side of the spring isn't pushed up against the disconnector enough, so I'll have to do that later on. But this is just literally to offer this up. So pull the hammer back, click the knocker valve down, and then slide the slide on. Where's the, there it is, slide stop. And we just put the slide stop in, click the slide stop on, and away she goes. Now, other parts that I've used in order to make it look like this pistol is the thumb safety is a standard 4.3 thumb safety. The slide stop, obviously I can't get a Wilson single spar slide stop, so I've had to use the 5.1 slide stop. It looks okay. This is the trigger from the Desert Warrior, which are fitted. Again, it's a black trigger on this one. The only difference is the frame itself and these two parts of the furniture, which aren't blued or chrome blued, whatever it is on there. I've done mine just black. As I say, it's only to represent this pistol, it's not to actually look identical to it. So there you are, I've put my own black walnut grips on. It's got a checkered mainspring housing. Again, this is off of a standard 1911 A1, but I've used my standard MD or MMD filler, which I've told you about in the past, to fill the two holes in and where the lanyard loop goes. Fill them in and then just spray it and away you go. The other side, again using the standard 1911 A1 pins. The hammer is a 4.3 black combat hammer. Sights, again 4.3, which I explained in the other video. So there you go, that's it. The mag release, unfortunately, I believe, yeah, the mag release on there is a serrated one. I haven't actually got one in my spares box, I've still to get that. So I fitted a checkered, but it doesn't really matter. I mean, as I say, this is only meant to represent that pistol. The other thing that I've noticed is, which a lot of people say you can get away without using them. I personally prefer to use it. It's there for a reason. I haven't got one in my spares box at the moment, so it's a bit dodgy at the moment. But I don't know if you can see. If I hold that up to the light, you might be able to see it. See the gap between the frame and the slide? You can just see the recoil spring through there. That should be a lot smaller than that. See, I can just squeeze that down. The reason being is, if I take this off and show you, the reason being is there is no slide spacer piece in there. Now, this is a part made by Tanya Koba. I believe I've said about it in other videos. All it does is it allows you to fit high kappa based slides to a standard 1911 frame. Now, you can live without them. I mean, I've test fired this, I've used it again yesterday, fired lovely. As I say, I was getting double trigger problems, but that's not associated with this, that's to do with the sear. To do with the disconnector, sorry. So, as far as I'm aware, she fires okay. But for longevity and to stop this slide moving up and down, you do need that slide spacer in there. So if you want it as your main pistol that you're going to be using a lot, get a slide spacer. It's worth it. Okay, I'll slide that on there. I believe the only place you can get those slide spacers from is War Games Club from Hong Kong. Anyway, there we go. That's the pistol, ball barrel. It's got a single or small recoil guide, which is as per the real steel. Everything else, that's a 4.3, which I've just ground down the edge, the front there, to make it look shiny, the same as the original real steel one, which you can't really see on there because it protrudes out the end. I can't do that, so I've just done that. As I say, it's a bit out of my spares box as well, so... But there you have it. So I've done the... don't really know what they call these. I presume it's chin cutouts, I don't know, but it's just to aid in holstering the pistol. At least that's what I've been led to believe by the real steel guys. So I've done that, ground that down on the slide, but other than that, it's just a 4.3 slide fitted to a standard 1911 A1 frame. So there you go, that's my take on the Bill Wilson custom carry pistol. I hope you enjoyed it. And there'll be other projects up and coming in the near future. Okay, this is Lazouche Custom Shop. So